Hello everyone, welcome back to the course of Core Java, and today in our lesson number 26 we will see a practical example of interface. Okay, so we will see how we can create a stack using interface, right? So first let's understand what a stack is. So stack is just a data structure. Okay, it's a data structure. For example, you have a book, and on top of one book you put another book, and so on, you keep repeating. So that creates a stack of books, right? So similar to it only, like for example, you insert one data and then you insert another. So like that, one after another, you insert a data. But the speciality of stack is that it will be last in, first out. Keep in mind, LIFO, last in, first out. That means the last data that you enter in the stack will be the first one to out. Okay, a stack follows two protocol. That is, it will have one push function. That means you will enter a number of data, right? That is called the push function, and then it will follow the pop function. Okay, pop means the data that you entered last. Okay, as I said, last in, first out. The data that you entered last, it will be the first one to be popped out. That means the one to be expelled from the stack. Okay, so hope you understood stack. And if you are new to data structure, then we are actually planning a course on data structure as well, and we will try to bring that course for you as soon as possible. But for now, just understand what is the basic functionality of a stack. Okay, so coming to our next subtopic, that is using interface, right? For this stack we'll use an interface. As per our previous lesson, we know that interface defines a protocol, like it's a form of abstraction that says that this method needs to be implemented whenever you implement an interface. Okay, for example, I already have a code here, code of the interface. Let's say this interface is there, and I gave it the name int stack, and in that, as I said, a stack must have this two operation, right? Push and pop. Okay, so this is mandatory, you cannot skip this. So now, as I have defined this, declared this two method in this int stack interface, that means whichever class implements this will have to follow this. Okay, will have to implement this method as well. Okay, so as part of our protocol, as part of our understanding of interface, it provides a protocol that whatever stack implements this interface, it has to implement push and pop. Okay, so for that purpose we have two kind of stack. One is fixed stack, that means it will have a fixed limit. Okay, a kind of fixed limit. So that is our fixed stack. And a dynamic stack, that means suppose you give a fixed limit to that stack, but once that limit is fulfilled, that means size of the stack is fulfilled, then it will dynamically increase the size of the stack. Okay, both will remain same, right? Both this push and pop will remain same. That means the operation name will remain same, and both this fixed and dynamic stack has to implement them. Okay, but the implementation will be different, right? So let's first start with our fixed stack. Okay, so when I write implements int stack, just hover over it and click on add unimplemented method. Okay, so immediately Eclipse will write this code for us. Okay, so this override is an annotation. We will explain this in our later classes, you can just ignore it for now. So a stack we can represent as an array, right? We can use an array to represent our stack. So let's say private, we'll use the access specifier, we'll keep our stack as private. Okay, let's name it stack. Okay, we have a stack array of integer type, then we'll have top. Okay, top means, as I said, a stack, what it is, it will be like one on the top of another, right? So the top will define the limit till which your data has been fulfilled. For example, the first data is entered in the stack, then top will be, let's say, 0. Using our array index, it will be 0. Then second data is there, then top will be 1. Like that we will maintain. Okay, so we will have a constructor here. For example, let's make it public, fix stack. Okay, it will take size, right? Then stack equals to new int size, right? And your top equals to -1. Okay, for now it will be -1 because at the starting your stack will be empty. Okay, so whenever a item, that means an integer data, is pushed in the stack, obviously we will push it inside the array only, right? So it will be like this, and we will increment that top. Okay, so if any of the code is feeling difficult for you, then please visit our previous videos in this course, Core Java course, because this increment, array and method, everything is already explained in our previous classes. Okay, so when a item, that means a data, is pushed in the in our push method, at that time we need to push the data inside the method, sorry, inside the array. Okay, but what happens if your top, that means if your stack is full, how we will decide that? That we will decide something like stack dot length. Stack dot length, already I explained, stack dot length will just display the size of your array. Okay, this top will keep a count of your index, and this stack dot length will give you the total size of the array. Okay, what size we allocated, that size it will give, right? We'll just put -1 because of course index will be 0 to length -1, right? If index is this, then we will print something out like stack is full. Okay, it will print stack is full, and in case of pop, we will just return, sorry, it will return stack top --, right? So it will keep returning the value, but we need to handle one more case. For example, the stack is empty, that means top is -1 equal to -1. At that time it will return something like, it will return 0 by default. Okay, and let's make it print something, right? Let's make it print stack is empty. Okay, this should work fine. Let's write our main class. We'll just test this. Sample main, we'll create this, and we'll use the interface, as I said, to create our reference variable. This will be our fixed stack equals to new fixed stack. We'll put a size like this. Okay, then let's use a for loop. Okay, and say we want to fill it till 5 only, till the top, and then we'll use the push. Okay, the push method that we just defined, dot push, we'll put I, right? For int, same thing we can write actually. We'll write like this, but here we don't need to pass anything, right? We will simply write fixed stack dot pop. Okay, so when we run this, we will get an output like this. Okay, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so this push we will not see because we did not print anything for normal push, so we are not seeing anything. But after that, when we are popping, we are getting value like 4301, right? That is the stack. That means 0 entered first, 1, then 2 and 3. While exiting, that means while popping, it is 4 is coming out first, then 3, then 2, then 1, then 0. Let's make it like 6, okay? And then it will be 7. Just for testing purpose, we'll do this. Then we'll run this code, okay? Okay, array out of bound, right? So that is because we did not handle exception, right? We did not handle the exception. So exception handling is another topic that we'll learn in our future class. So that is not an issue. So let's just keep it like this for now. Okay, so actually we had handled our code, but it's still giving us exception, right? Exception is another topic, that is fine, but our stack should be able to handle the stack is full, right? So that means we may have missed something. So in push code, if you see in push code, we are printing stack is full, but and then again we are checking, we are entering this value, right? So this should be inside our, it should be inside our else. So that is the mistake. So if we put it inside our else, I think now it should work fine. Okay, it should work fine now. We'll make it 7 only. Let's see. So when I run this, I'll get something like this. Okay, stack is full is coming once, because only once the limit of the stack is exceeded. That means till 5 bit is supported and we put 6. That means only once the stack is full should be printed, only once it exceeded the limit. Okay, and in the case of pop, it exceeded the limit by twice, right? So if you scroll down, you will see two times we are getting the value of stack is empty. So that means our code is working fine, so we are able to implement our fixed stack. Okay, so now let's move on to our next topic, that is dynamic stack. Let's create a dynamic stack. It will also implement the same interface, implements int stack. Okay, then hover over it, just click on this, you'll get the same method that needs to be implemented mandatorily. Okay, so inside this, the same code will be required. I'll just copy it to save some time. Okay, then again what we need is a constructor. Okay, we'll get the constructor, and code here will remain the same, at least till here it will remain same. Okay, new int size, then your top equals to -1, right? It will be -1 here. Your stack, this code will also remain same because this is a basic code, right? It will be item, we'll push the item. But here, as I said, we are using a dynamic stack. Okay, for example, top equals to stack dot length -1, then we need some other code. Okay, here we need to declare the else so that we don't face similar issue as the last case. Okay, just declare this. Now we need to make it dynamic, right? That means whenever the stack is full, we need to increase the size of the stack. Okay, so let's create a temporary array here, and the size of this array we will give stack dot length. We'll just increase the size of the stack by double. Okay, we'll increase the size by double. Then we will use a for loop. We'll use the for loop to assign the values to the new array. Okay, we'll just assign the values to a new array. That means it will be like stack.length, that means whatever value of our original stack, those values will be assigned to this new array temp, okay, temporary array. Just add plus plus, then what we need to do, I equals to stack I, okay. Simply we are assigning the value, nothing complicated here, simply we are assigning the values, okay. Now what we'll do, we will exchange the array, okay. Exchange the array means, what I mean by exchange is that when we initialize the stack array, it had a size of something, this variable whatever we'll pass, for example we pass 5, okay. So after that, when the stack is full, then we are creating a temporary array of double the length, that means it will have the size 10. After it is done, we put the value of the stack inside the temporary array, we will simply assign this whole temporary array to the stack. That means this stack, right, this array new int size, that will be forgotten, okay, that will be forgotten. Instead, your stack will now become new int stack length into 2, okay. So that is the concept. And once it is done, simply we will input the values like usual, okay, there is no change here. And then in case of pop, the code should remain largely same, okay, because whenever, even if your stack is full, we are changing the length of your stack, that means size of your stack, and then top is increased, only top is increased. So that means the pop uses only the top function, right, that means the top variable to limit is whether it's empty or not. So we can use this same top variable, same logic, so there should not be any issue, okay. And if any issue, then don't worry, like in coding you should not be scared of error, okay, because error is very much common when you go to a project. At that time when you write big code, at that time error is very common, so you should not be scared, you should slowly learn the skill of debugging it, okay, just learn the skill of debugging, okay. So now we'll use something like this, then just assign dynamic stack, this time we'll make it 10, okay. Now we'll start with 2, not an issue because this is a dynamic stack. So now once it is done, the code should be quite similar, right, code should be similar, okay. So instead of fixed stack, we will give dynamic, then same case here, we'll give dynamic, okay. So here, okay, it will be dynamic stack, right. So let's first just see the example of this, let's run this once, okay. So you see, I gave the sizes 2, but even then I am able to input all of my data till 6, I am able to input 6 length, that means the value would be 0 to 5, right, 0 to 5 I am able to input easily, and I am able to pop this as well. And when it came to the 7th, only one gave as stack is empty, because obviously we put the value till 6 only, okay, we put the value till 6 only. Just to give you a clear example how the size changed, size of the stack changed, let's print this, okay, let's print the size of the stack, like display, just for example, display, then says out, we will call, okay, size of stack is, right, it will be stack dot length, okay, it will be, return type will be void. Then here if you see this code, what I will do, I don't want to print the display again and again, so let's print it when, let's say I equals to 1 or I equals to 4, right? This is just for checking purpose, okay? Just to understand, like, what is the current size of the stack that we are using in this dynamic array. Just to understand that, we'll use this dynamic stack, we'll use this, okay? It was display . So here it is giving me error because I use the interface reference, right? I use the interface reference. So it here, this display is not present in the interface. That's why it's giving me error. So for now, I'll just change it to this class only. Okay. So when I change it to class, this error will be removed. Okay. So just understand the code. What I'm doing, there is no special condition. Okay. So no need to worry about this. What I am doing is once two value, that means 0 and 1, once the second value will be entered, at that time we'll see the size of the stack, and then again when it will be 4, that means almost the last element, at that time again we will see. Okay, this is just, you can consider a code for debugging. Okay, let's run this. So you see, if you scroll up, you get two output, right? So when I was 1, you could see stack display, it was printing stack dot length, right? At that point the stack was 2, the next was stack is 4. Okay, same will be there. Let's say I am changing this 6 to 16. Okay, just for example, I'm changing it to 16, and then it should print like I, next it should print at 10, and I it should print at 14. Okay, it should be similar, actually double, right? Okay, let's see. Okay, see, it got doubled, right? I think 6 will be a better example. Let's see. Yeah, 6 is a better example. See, when the I was 1, at that time the stack is, the size of the stack is 2, and then it doubled to 4, then to 8, then to 16. So you see, that is how our dynamic stack will work. Okay, and it popped till 9. Okay, it popped till 9. So once the pop is done, if I print the values again inside that dynamic stack, you will see it will still have remaining values, right? So till 15 to 9 is popped, that means 0 to 8 this stack will still have. Okay, so that is like a homework for you. You can try to print the remaining value of the stack in this class itself by writing a method in this class. Okay, so hope you understood what stack is and how interface provides a protocol for us to implement some operations in our class. Hope you understood this, what is a fixed stack, what is dynamic stack, and how to implement them using interface. So this is like almost the end of our Core Java series for beginners, but don't worry, we are soon going to start a new course that will be more about deep dive into the Core Java. That means it will handle exception handling, and it will also, we will also teach collection framework, how we can handle files, multi-threading. Then we will also learn about RMI, remote method invocation, and computer networking. So whatever in-depth things are there in Core Java, we will learn in our upcoming playlist, okay, upcoming course. So stay tuned for that course as well, because this course was mainly focused for beginners. Like, if you want to learn Java as a beginner and you just want the basics of Java, then this course is enough. But if you started liking Java, or you already love Java, then you should learn more about Java in deep. Okay, the main things like exception handling, collection framework, those everything will be taught in our upcoming course. Okay, so soon the name of the course will be announced, and we will start this course in less than a week. Okay, so not to worry, there will not be a large gap. Almost immediately we are going to start our next course. So about today's course and the whole today's lesson and the whole course. If you have any doubt, then feel free to comment down below. We will surely try to clear your doubts. And like and share with your friends, whoever is interested in learning Java. And do subscribe to our channel so that you get notified about the upcoming Java intermediate, or you can say Java masterclass course. Okay. And you can also follow us on Instagram so that you get notified from there as well. Okay. Link is in the description below. Thank you for attending our course, and do provide us your feedback, because that will help us in improving our future courses. That will help us to structure it better for you guys. Thank you.